Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. If you have multiple photos that were shot at the same time and want to transpose the face from one photo to another, I'll show you how to do it. Open a photo that has a face you'd like to replace, as well as the photo of the face you'd like to replace it with. I downloaded these from Shutterstock.com. The first step is to bring the preferred face onto the other photo. To do this, open your rectangular marquee tool and drag a selection over the face and shoulders. We'll cut it out from the background and copy it to its own layer by pressing Ctrl or Command J. To place it onto the other photo, press V to open your Move tool and drag it up onto the tab of your other photo. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down onto the image and release. We need to resize and position it. First, let's reduce its opacity so we can see the other face under it. Open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Drag it over the other face. To resize it, go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Shift as you drag it out or in. Size it as close as you can to the face under it. If you want to angle it, go to a corner, and this time, when you see a curved double arrow, rotate it. Drag it over the other face until they are generally lined up. Don't be concerned if it's not perfect at this point. You'll be able to finesse its size and position later. Press Enter or Return to accept it. Bring the opacity back to 100% and click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask. Invert the layer mask by pressing Ctrl or Command I. Making the layer mask black masks out or hides the face layer. Think of layer masks as stencils. Black masks out while white reveals. We're going to reveal the face through the layer mask by brushing in white. But first, let's zoom in. Press Z to open your Zoom tool and drag your tool over the area. If you want to move your image, press and hold the space bar as you drag it over. Open your brush tool and brush picker. We'll take care of the size in a moment. Make the hardness 0% and the opacity and flow 100%. To make your brush larger or smaller, press the right or left bracket key on your keyboard. Our foreground color needs to be white. If your background color is white, invert the colors by pressing X on your keyboard. Brush over the face to reveal the new face in Layer 1. To reveal back areas of the background, press X on your keyboard to invert your foreground and background colors. Adjust the size of your brush if you need to. Then, brush over those areas. Blend in the new face as much as you can. Don't be concerned if there are areas of the background that can't be retouched at this point. We'll take care of that next. Once you've retouched it as much as you can, make a composite snapshot by pressing Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E on Windows or Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac. Zoom into the area you want to retouch. Open your Clone Stamp tool by pressing S on your keyboard. Adjust the size of your tool relative to the area you're going to retouch. Alt-click or Option-click on your source area and brush over the target area you want to clone it with. When you're done retouching all the areas, fit your document back onto your canvas by pressing Ctrl or Command 0. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.